Saeed's asking you to get out there and constantly travel. And so you're traveling all over. You've got kids at home that are missing their mom. You're got incredible stress. You're being verbally, psychologically, emotionally abused by your husband. All of this, and the pressure finally gets to the point where you break down in front of a pastor and his wife, Dr. David Chadwick, who you were speaking at his church. And describe what happened and why the light bulb went on when he said to you, Nagme, you're being abused.
Yeah, the pressure had built up. October. I'd just done Saeed's prayer vigil, and I traveled 3 or 4 times in September. I had traveled to North Carolina. I'd spoken at a Baptist women's conference, then flown all the way to California, spoken at Joshua Springs Calvary Chapel. And then I was back again, North Carolina, speaking at Dr. Chadwick's church. I was exhausted. I hadn't talked to Saeed for a week because after my trip to Joshua Springs, Calvary Chapel, Saeed had called me all sorts of names. And for the first time, I drew a boundary. I basically said, Saeed, if you can't be nice to me, I'm not going to talk to you anymore. Don't call me. And he didn't call me again. He didn't call me even when he got out of prison. And my only request was, if you can't be nice to me, don't call. And so he didn't call. So I hadn't talked to Saeed for a week before I flew to Pastor Chadwick's church. And not having talked to him, I was just broken, because a big part of me still loved him. I wanted our family together. And I just couldn't make sense why he would attack me when I was laying down my life. And finally, I spilled the beans. I just said, Pastor Chadwick, I don't understand this. This is how it's been. This is how it is. Why would he attack me from prison? And he said, Nagme, do you know I'm not just a pastor? I have a doctorate degree. And I said, no, I didn't know that. He said, yeah, and my doctorate degree is in psychology. And he said, Nagme, you're an abused wife.
And you had never, till that point, admitted that to yourself?
No, it's kind of like you see stuff, but you don't put it together. It's kind of like you have a back pain, your body aches, there's different things, and you're eating Advil or Tylenol. And then you go to the doctor and says, oh, you're a stage 4 colon cancer. And you're like, oh, this is why all these symptoms. Tylenol doesn't fix it. A lot of times women under abuse start developing autoimmune, which I did. Most women I know have autoimmune diseases. And so I just couldn't put all of it together until Pastor Chadwick gave me that diagnosis, and everything made sense.